Hello everyone, today we will be creating a simple project to load images into our image view using a library called Picasso. This is one of the simplest ways of loading images in Android. So first thing we need to do, we need to open the Android Studio and press that button to create a new project. We're gonna call our project, let's say, image view load. Okay, we don't need to check any of those, press next. Targeting API, I'll leave this one. API 18 is fine because we're gonna be able to run it on 91.4% of devices, which is good enough, I think, especially for our project. So let's say next. Let's select the basic activity. Why? Because I want to reuse that button over there. I want to press that button and be able to show the image over there. So let's say next. Main activity, we'll leave it as it is, and we don't need a fragment because it's a very simple project and we don't need to any complication of fragment activities. Let's say finish. Alright, so where we need to go now is actually resources, layout and content main. Okay, and there are two ways of showing the how the elements are appearing in UI. First thing, we can just visually modify those elements over there, add new elements. As you can see, it visually appears like it will be when the app is launched. But we also can modify those attributes over there in the text section. So this is how it appears. And as you can see, the XML file which defines the UI is separated in two files, activity main as well as content main. But if we go to activity main, we see that activity main just includes the content main, so just include layout attribute over there. So this has been done just for simplicity, I guess, so the developer can just see separately the main attributes of activity as well as just the crucial content of that. So let's modify it. So we don't need this hello world text. I'm gonna press the delete button to remove it. Second thing I want to modify, okay, I cannot modify it in content mail, so I need to go to activity main, design, and I can select a floating action bar over there. As you can see, the icon here showing a mail. Well, basically our application is not related to mail in any way, so we need to modify our icon to be something else. And let's see, we can just select it over the source combat, this button. We can select, let's say, play icon. As you can see, there's IC media play icon. Okay, all right, so now it's a play button. What we need to do next is we want to add image view over there. So once we press this button, the image will be loading in image view. So now we need to add our image view. So we go to content main, we select images, image view, and we drag it here. It asks for default icon to be appearing when we launched our app, so we select this one, image. Okay. So as we can see, we can now just modify the height, width of the image view, but honestly, it's not the best way I have found. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna change it programmatically. So as we can see, those attributes are there, and it says exactly absolute X, absolute Y, so it shows those dimensions manually. We don't want this, so we're gonna remove it. And what we're gonna change here, instead of all those manual values, we're gonna input layout width match parent. So you're gonna match the parent view. Match parent. Okay. So you see it will be centered this way, and this is exactly what we need. Okay, so once we are done with the how UI are going to appear, we are going to go to the Java itself and modify the code. As you can see, there is already floating action bar defined, so once we press the button, there's a banner at the bottom displaying the text that we want. We're just going to modify the default text and change it to the one that we want. Okay, so we need a way to actually show an image, and as I said before, we're gonna be using the Picasso library. The way how we can add the Picasso library is quite simple. So here we can see the Gradle scripts. So what is a Gradle? Gradle is a basically built system for Android. It takes care of dependencies and how libraries are attached to our application, and basically it's a very powerful thing. So we need this file build grade module app, so we need to modify it here. So as you can see, there are dependencies. We need to add additional dependency over there. Okay, so let's add it to the bottom. As we can find on Picasso website, so this is the dependency we need: compile square Picasso library. Then we're gonna press sync now. All right, so now we can use the Picasso library. Okay, so now we have added dependency to our Picasso library in our project, but before using the Picasso library, we need to define our image view in the code itself. So we need to match XML file to our implementation. So let's type image view. All right. So, and then let's call this as image view. Then image view. Find view by ID. And here we're gonna select an ID from an XML file. How to check it out? Okay, we need to go to XML file itself. It was defined in the content main, so we're gonna go here. We're gonna in the text version, and the name of it is ImageView. Okay, so we're going back, and we define this R, which means resources, ID, then ImageView. ImageView. Okay. Okay, so now we can actually use it in our code. So we can just type Picasso.with. This parameter over there asks, so application asks to enter a context. To get the context of application, it's a simple command: get application context. Then next thing is we need to specify the URL we want to load. So let's have, let's select this one. URL I want to show is, for example, this one. So this is the path, load, and we need to specify a target where we actually want to load. So we specify this into, and as we already defined the image view in our code, we just select this image view. Okay, so basically it should work. Let's see if it's working out. We select our simulator to run on, press OK button. Okay, so this is the default image that I specified for our image view. And we now press the button. It says loading image, as I said, the banner. But guys, you can see nothing have loaded. You know why? The reason that nothing have loaded is because even though we specified the URL over there, we forgot to specify our network permission. Every application that uses internet need to have a specified permission in the manifest file over there. So we need to add the internet permission to our manifest file. As you can see, it's not defined over there. How to add it? It's quite simple. So to add our internet permission, we just open the Android manifest file and we just add this line: uses permission Android internet. Okay, so now we can launch it again and see. We press the button again, loading image, and boom, here it is. This is our image that we have loaded. It works perfectly fine. Okay guys, so as you can see, the Picasso library is quite powerful. It has a very easy syntax, but it allows to do many things. For example, it allows to do resizes. Let's say you have an image of certain size and you can just resize it programmatically. You can as well adjust the way the image appears in your image view, for example, doing this function center crop. Things that you can do as well include, for example, if you have an error, let's say there is a network connectivity problem, you can specify the image that appears instead of the image that you wanted to display. So that's quite helpful, I think. Also, what you can do, you can just load a resource from your project. So you don't need to download something from the internet. You can just specify the file like that. It will be also perfectly fine. So yeah, I recommend using this library. I use it a lot as well, and it's very, very great. Thank you for watching. Please press the like button if you like that video. Subscribe to my channel. There will be more tutorials, and I really enjoy doing those. So I hope you enjoy it too. Okay, thank you very much, and goodbye.